Hello all. In this video, we are going to learn about connection pooling. What is connection pool? So, a connection pool is a pool which is created by the container where all the connections will be placed inside a pool. So, why connection pool is needed? So, let's suppose I have a application which is running in the production and through my application, I have made a query, and whenever I am making a query, so in that time a connection is established. So let's suppose I have one connection and I have raised a query, and that query will fetch data from the database and release the connection. But what happens if the first query does not release the connection? So On the same time, if I will hit a second query, so because there is no connection, because already there is one connection and that is using by the first query, so I will get a too many clients issue. So for overcome this type of scenario, we have to maintain the connection pool concept in our microservices. So let's discuss how we are going to maintain. So first of all, you have to check the Spring Boot version. Before Spring Boot, there is a Tomcat container, so that container creates the connection pool. But if we jump over the Spring Boot, so Spring Boot provides a Hikari connection pool. A Hikari connection pool is a very strong and robust connection pool provided by the Spring Boot. So first of all, we need to check which version of Spring Boot we are using. If we are using Spring Boot version less than 2, then if you want to implement the connection pooling in your application, then you have to add this dependency in your pom.xml file. In our case, let me see the pom.xml file. If you see here the Spring Boot version, if you see the Spring Boot version is 2, we are using Spring Boot version 2, so no need to add that dependency inside the pom.xml file, because Spring Boot automatic provide the Hikari connection pooling with Spring Boot version 2, so this dependency is not needed. But if your version is less than 2, then you have to add this dependency inside your pom.xml file, right? The second thing, if your version is less than 2, you need to add data source in your application.properties file. So in our case, my version is 2, so no need to add this data source in my application.properties file, because if you are adding these two jars, I mean one of these two jars, the Spring Boot Starter JDBC or Spring Boot Starter Data JPA, if you have one of these jars, that means it will automatically provide Hikari data source, so no need to mention it explicitly, right? So if you check the application.properties file, I haven't mentioned this data source. The profile.active is local. This is my port number, and this is the DB URL. I am using the in-memory database, the H2 database. This is my driver name, username, password, and this is my dialect. But here I haven't used the Hikari data source. Why? Because my Spring Boot version is greater than 2 or 2. Now the third thing, so this I covered, right? If your Spring Boot version is greater than or equal to 2, so you have to add only one of this dependency. Either you can use Spring Boot Starter JDBC or you can use Spring Boot Starter Data JPA. So what I have used here Yeah, I used Spring Boot Starter Data JPA. So because of that, no need to add Hikari data source in properties file and no need to add Hikari connection pooling dependency in pom.xml file. But if your version is less than 2, then you have to add this dependency in your pom.xml file and this data source in your properties.xml file, right? Now, what all connection attributes we need to save our application so that we will not get a too many clients issues. The first of all, spring.datasource.hikari.connection.timeout. This is in millisecond. So after 4 millisecond, if the data is not coming from the database, then we will get the connection timeout error. This is why minimum idle time is 5. This is the maximum pool size. So there is a one pool. Inside one pool, we have a max 8 connections, not more than the 8 connections, right? If you want to increase or decrease, you can increase or decrease through here. This is the idle timeout. How many milliseconds one connection will sit idle? So if you want to increase or decrease, you can do it from here. This is the max lifetime, and this is the auto commit. So let's suppose you made some changes, and if you want to auto commit through the application.properties file, then you can do it here true. In my case, I don't want, so I have given here false, right? So let me run this application so that I will show you the console logs. And this project you can find out from the Git. The Git link I have provided in the description part of this video. You can go through the code, you can download it, and you can use it. So the user controller is this one. Okay, so let me hit the endpoint. It got started. Let me hit the endpoint. I got the output. Now if you check in the logs, see here, sorry, you can see Hikari side. Are you able to see Hikari data source? I haven't provided any data source to my application.properties file, but since my version is more than 2, so here you can see the data source this application is using, that is the Hikari data source, right? And the next line, so you can see here Hikari data source is starting. The message is Hikari pool 1 is starting, and once the transaction is completed, then the message is Hikari pool 1 is start completed, right? So this is the way how we can manage connections in microservices. Hope you learn. We will meet in next video. If you have any doubt, any comments, then you can please provide the comments in the video part. I will provide you the solution for that. Thank you.